Okay, welcome back to bioinformatics and one section. Today we are going to discuss about protein structures and its determination. Okay, before going to the in detail, you should know what is protein and what is amino acids and how many types of amino acids are there. Hopefully you have already studied in your previous subject. So, so you know there are four types of structure level, four level of structure in proteins, and these are the four types. The first thing is the primary structure, and primary structure is the just order of amino acids. All those types of amino acids are the faster sequence that we have used in our practical experiments. Jitne bhi hum faster sequence hum lete the aur hum usko use kar rahe the practical session ke andar ya hum isse pehle jitne bhi lectures mein, so all those sequences were belongs to primary structure, right? Humne unme se एक दो लेक्चर थे जिनमें के अंदर हम प्रोटीन स्ट्रक्चर प्रोडक्शन भी किया है, दैट वाज रिलेटेड टू आवर प्रैक्टिकल सेशन, बट मोस्ट ऑफ द एनालिसिस दैट्स वेयर रिलेटेड टू द सीक्वेंस मींस दोस सीक्वेंस वेयर बिलोंग टू द प्राइमरी स्ट्रक्चर. ओके, सो प्राइमरी स्ट्रक्चर के बारे में हम इसमें यू नो ऑलरेडी, and this is then second level of protein structure is the secondary structure. Okay, secondary, in case of secondary structure there are two types of structure, and sometimes there may be three types of structure. The first structure is known as alpha helix, and the second protein structure is known as beta sheets and turns. Okay, we will discuss in detail about secondary structure in the coming slides. Then when these secondary structure refold itself, then it form a 3D three-dimensional structure that's known as tertiary structure. So tertiary structure is very important because this is the functional structural as well as functional unit of protein. Okay, it can work independently and it can represent a single function. If a gene has a multiple domain, it means there are multiple tertiary structure, and definitely it will perform multiple function. As yesterday we have discussed in our domain analysis के अंदर हमने ये देखा था कि हमारे पास एक सीक्वेंस है और एक सीक्वेंस के अंदर there were more than one domains, right? So it means each domain is representing the tertiary structure. हर एक domain उसके अंदर that was independently functional, and each domain form a tertiary structure. Then next is quaternary structure. When more than two or more than two tertiary structure join to form a complex form of protein assembly, that's assembly known as quaternary structure. You know, protein are mostly found in the form of complex structure because in any system, due to the complexity of the living system, एक आपके पास अगर एक प्रोटीन है तो इट्स डिफिकल्ट टू इंडिपेंडेंटली परफॉर्म इट्स फंक्शन. सो होता क्या है, जितने भी आप कोई मैकेनिज्म अगर आप पढ़ते हैं तो यू रीड अबाउट द इंट्रैक्शन ऑफ वन प्रोटीन विद द अनदर प्रोटीन. ओके, फॉर एग्जांपल इन केस ऑफ हेमोग्लोबिन, यू नो इन केस ऑफ हेमोग्लोबिन हाउ मनी यूनिट्स आर देयर, कोई बता सकते हैं हाउ मनी यूनिट्स आर देयर? हेमोग्लोबिन के केस में यू नो दैट इज एन एग्जांपल ऑफ गुड एग्जांपल ऑफ क्वार्टरनरी स्ट्रक्चर. और उस जो हेमोग्लोबिन के अंदर देर आर फोर यूनिट्स, ठीक है, टू अल्फा एंड टू बीटा यूनिट्स. इट्स मीन्स फोर टर्शरी स्ट्रक्चर, फोर टर्शरी स्ट्रक्चर्स कंबाइन करके एक कम्प्लेक्स बनाता है, और वो कम्प्लेक्स क्या होता है, हेमोग्लोबिन. And then in the form of complex form, that's our that's will be able to carry oxygen from one side to the other side. So quaternary structure is known as an advanced structure and our assembly of proteins. Okay, then this is what we have already discussed about in during our sequence alignment lecture. So the homologs are the conserved regions are very important due to their function. Jo aapke paas 3D structure hota hai, agar if there are two proteins and both have similar 3D structure, it means both have similar conserved residues. Okay, so conserved residues are the finding of conserved residues is important with respect to identification of their function. Then motif, what is a motif? Even this term we have already discussed in during our practical session. What is motif? Motif is a short conserved sequence pattern that's associated with distinct functions of a function or a structure of a protein or DNA. Okay, for example, in a tertiary structure, you know, tertiary structure is a 3D dimensional structure. There may be several motifs. एक ही domain के अंदर बहुत सारे motifs होते हैं. छोटे-छोटे motifs combine होके एक 3D structure बनाता है. So each motif may have structural function, might be a part of functional part or structural part of 3 dimensional protein, 3D structure. जो टर्शरी स्ट्रक्चर है इसका या तो ये स्ट्रक्चरल पार्ट हो सकता है मोटिफ, या ये फंक्शनल पार्ट हो सकता है. फंक्शनल पार्ट का मतलब ये है कि जो एक्टिव रीजन्स में, एक्टिव रीजन के रीजन में जो मोटिफ्स हैं वो फंक्शनल पार्ट्स हैं. अगर उस एक्टिव रीजन को सपोर्ट करने वाले साइट्स पे जो मोटिफ्स हैं उनको हम स्ट्रक्चरल मोटिफ्स कहेंगे, राइट. देन दिस इज जस्ट एग्जाम्पल ऑफ मोटिफ्स. We can find conserved motifs using multiple sequence alignment, and in this case this is the three dimensional structure of protein with the surface. Agar aap solvent form mein hain, aap is different colors are representing their conservativity, conservedness and diversity. Okay, for example, these colors are representing the same or the high 100% conserved residues. ये एक domain है, उस domain के अंदर ये जो colors हैं, different colors, ये colors show कर रहे हैं कि ये residues इस domain के अंदर conserved हैं. Even different genes हो, belonging to the same group, same family से different genes हो or different proteins हो, but उनके दरमियान ये conserved रहेगा if they belong to the same family, right. This color represents generally similar amino acids, and this color different shows the different amino acids. Okay, only limited amount of protein surface is well conserved. Here is a statement. Jo protein surface hai, protein surface means upper side pe jo area hai wo mostly डाइवर्स होते हैं एक प्रोटीन से दूसरे प्रोटीन के साथ. बिकॉज दिस इज द पार्ट दैट्स आर इन्वॉल्व इन द फंक्शन. जो इनसाइड पे प्रोटीन है, यू नो देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ प्रोटीन. सम प्रोटीन्स आर फाउंड इन ब्रीड इनसाइड द प्रोटीन. 3D स्ट्रक्चर अगर आप इस 3D को कंसिडर करें तो सम प्रोटीन विल बी इनसाइड द 3D स्ट्रक्चर एंड सम प्रोटीन विल बी एट द सर्फेस ऑफ द प्रोटीन. सो those protein which are part of core protein, core structure means jo internal structure ko maintain karne wale proteins hai, breed hai, those are mostly conserved. But the protein those are found on the surface ke upar jo amino acids hain, those will be diverse from protein to protein. due to because these are the important protein that may interact with other protein or other ligands. Okay, so here is the simple structure of amino acid, and there are four groups of functional groups. Central carbon, this is a central carbon, and the amino group and carboxyl group and the side chain. Side chain R, you know, R is a very important. The diversity in 20 amino acids are due to the structural difference of the R group, right? The remaining part, that's amide and carboxyl part, are similar in all 20 amino acids, okay? And these amino acid join together through condensation process by the removal of water and form a peptide bond. This is a peptide bond, C double bond, O, then C bond, NH. This is known as peptide bond. And peptide bond is the backbone of protein structure, okay? So most of the amino acids are found in the form of alpha amino acids, and so only little a bit in nature found in beta amino acids. So the difference between alpha amino acid and beta amino acid is the position of amide group or amino group on alpha carbon or beta carbon. Alpha carbon hum jo first carbon hai yahan jo C double O ke sath, this one the jo central carbon hai, is carbon ko hum alpha carbon kehte hain. Okay, so iske sath agar direct hi jo amino group hai wo isi alpha carbon ke sath attached hai to wo alpha carbon hai. Normally abhi tak hum jitne amino acid pad chuke hain biochemistry ke andar ya dusre subject mein, wo sare ke sare humne discuss kiye hain alpha amino acids ko, kyunki these are the common amino acids in nature. Okay, but there are some amino acids with a little bit change. For example, agar yahan pe ek aur यहाँ CH के साथ यहाँ पे दरमियान में एक और CH आ जाए, ठीक है, C bond, then this is beta, ये beta carbon है, and this is alpha carbon, okay? So alpha carbon के साथ directly अगर amino group attached हो तो उसे हम alpha amino acid कहते हैं. अगर दरमियान में एक और carbon भी हो backbone के अंदर, so then this is known as beta amino acid. Right, this is the main difference between alpha amino and beta amino group. In this table, you can look here. There may be different additional molecules that may interact with the amino acids. Okay, for example, a phosphorylation is a process in which phosphate group attached on the R group, all R side chain, okay, at the by forming an phosphodiester bond between phosphate and R chain, and these are the residues which are involved in phosphorylation. Mostly hum dekhte hain jo agar aap dekhe na kinase protein, jaisa ki previous उसमें प्रैक्टिकल में भी हमने देखा कि हमने जब चेक किया हमारे प्रोटीन के अंदर तो उसमें काइनेज डोमेन था. अगर आप काइनेज डोमेन को देखें तो काइनेज डोमेन के अंदर मोस्टली सेरीन एंड थ्रियोनिन, दीज आर द मोस्ट टू अमाइनो एसिड व्हिच आर फ्रीक्वेंटली फाउंड, ओके, एंड दीज आर इन्वॉल्व इन फॉस्फोरिलेशन एंड डीफॉस्फोरिलेशन ऑफ प्रोटीन ऑफ अदर प्रोटीन एंड इट्सेल्फ. खुद को भी फॉस्फोरिलेशन और डीफॉस्फोरिलेशन कर सकते हैं और दूसरे को भी. Similarly, there may be also glycosylation at the by forming N glycosylation ka matlab hai ki R chain ke andar agar amino group hai aur amino group ke sath agar sugar molecule attach ho to use hum N glycosylation kehte hain. And this is the aspirin, what is the name of this amino acid? Asparagine. Okay, asparagine. Asparagine is an amino acid that has amino group in the R chain. Okay, so sugar molecule will attach with the amino group. Similarly, O-glycosylation means bonding of sugar molecule with the oxygen, and this will may occur on serine and threonine. Again, serine and threonine has the OH functional group. Is wajah se yahan pe sugar molecule O ke saath bind karta hai. Hydroxylation bhi possible hai, addition of OH group, carboxylation mein addition of COOH group bhi hota hai. So these are the additional molecule that can bind with R. Is R ke saath bind karta hai and that's give diversity to this amino acid. Is amino acid ke saath, jaisa ki hum biochemistry mein bhi hum padh chuke hain ki glycoprotein. ठीक है, glycoprotein means for a complex of glycogen and protein. So these are bound with the O glycosylation bond or N glycosylation bond. Then now we are at the second level of protein structure, that is secondary structure. And secondary structure, you know, there are three types of structure: alpha helix, beta sheets, and beta tan. So this is the first structure, alpha helix. And alpha helix, what is alpha helix? Alpha helix, in the alpha helix, the carbonyl oxygen of residues I means whatever amino acids form a hydrogen bond with the amide of residues I plus 4. Koi bhi I means yahan se agar aap start karte hain, to this is I. Agar aap yahan se start karte hain, to this is I. Iske baad jo fourth, next four amino acid hain, fourth amino acid, uske darmiyan yahan pe hydrogen bonding hota hai. Agar aap yahan pe dekh rahe hain, to this is one amino acid. Uske baad yahan se aake, this is fourth amino acid. So one and four, isko hum agar one consider kare, one and fourth ke darmiyan hydrogen bond banta hai. Theek hai, hydrogen bond kiske darmiyan banta hai? Carbonyl oxygen aur amide group ke darmiyan banta hai, because amide group has NH and carbonyl group has CO. So a hydrogen bond always form between hydrogen and oxygen. Okay, so these dots are showing the hydrogen bond. Due to the hydrogen bond, more than one hydrogen bond, if multiple hydrogen bonds combine, then it will give a strength to the alpha helix. Aapke paas ek helical like sheet banta hai, theek hai, helical like structure banta hai. So ye jo helical like structure hai, ye kiski wajah se banta hai? Hydrogen bond ki wajah se banta hai, theek hai. Then the second structure is the beta sheet. I am moving to next slide, because here I hopefully you have already studied this structure in your previous subject. Am I right? Am I right? Kya main sahi keh raha hu ki aap log ye pad chuke hain? Ya mazid isko detail mein padhne ki zarurat hai?
Yes sir.
Okay, main aap log pad chuke hain beta sheets. Anyhow, how we will discuss little bit. Similarly, in case of beta sheet, carbonyl oxygen and amide form a hydrogen bond. This is sheet like structure, and amino acid are arranged just like a sheet on one above the other. Is tarike se ek aapke paas parallel line mein, these may be in parallel direction or anti-parallel. Okay, parallel means both strands run from one direction to the another, and the anti-parallel means in a different direction. For example, this is one strand and this is another strand. These are anti-parallel to each other. Okay, ye ek dusre ke anti-parallel hai. Agar aap is sheet ko dekhte hain, to ye sheet aur ye sheet aapas mein parallel hai, theek hai. So parallel form mein, again, jo hydrogen bond hai, wo kiske darmiyan mein hai? Oxygen aur amide ke darmiyan mein. This is the hydrogen bond. This is a side view. This is a top view. Then the third one, that is little bit important for the formation of alpha helix and beta sheets. That is the beta turns. This is also known as tight turns or reverse turns. ये वो turns है जिसकी वजह से alpha sheets या beta alpha helix और beta sheet formation होती है. So beta sheets are the one of the most common structural motifs. This is a motif in the protein and change the direction of peptide backbone by nearly 180 degree, allowing the peptide chain to fall back on the itself. ठीक है, अब जितने भी अल्फा हेलिक्स हैं और बीटा शीट्स हैं उनको आपस में मजीद फॉल्ड करने के लिए एक दरमियान में टर्न्स होता है. फॉर एग्जांपल अगर हमें यहाँ पे लेट्स सपोज दिस इज अल्फा हेलिक्स. ओके, सो देयर इज अनदर अल्फा हेलिक्स, then there may be a sheet, then there may be another sheet like this. This may be a sheet. So these are the turns. Okay, look at this. These are the turns. This is a turn and this is a turn and this is, these are the turns. Okay, so due to these turns, the the secondary structures are folding itself again. Okay, आपको लग रहा है ये देखें, अगर ये turn यहाँ से निकाल दे तो it will just like a, या एक ही single sheet होगा या single ही helix होगा, right? So for the formation of 3D structure, the beta turns is very important in the protein structure. Okay, and what is the structural formation of beta turn? A beta turn is defined by the four consecutive residues. Again, this is four consecutive residues. If you are looking here, this is one residues, this is two, this is three, and this is fourth. ये four residues में होता है mostly. I one के साथ अगर आप start करते तो ये turns हैं. ठीक है? ये क्या है? Turns हैं. So less distance with the इनका जो दरमियान का distance है, one of that will be seven angstrom. And the turns lead to the reversal in the protein chain. Again, मैंने बताया कि this is in this direction. Due to the turns, protein is direction is changing. ये reverse हो रहा है. Similarly, ये beta sheets के अंदर आप देख रहे हैं तो ये दोबारा से reverse हो रहा है. Possible है यहाँ से दोबारा से इस side पे कोई helix बन जाए. So, it form a three. It allows the protein to form a 3D structure. ठीक है? And the rotation or the rotation in this terms are due to the torsional angles. The torsional angle we will discuss in the next slide with the torsional angle. Okay, beta turn structures can be further classified to various types according to the backbone torsional angles, phi bond and psi bond. Okay, in residues 1, 1+1, and 1+2, we will discuss in the next slide about torsional angles. Here are two types of beta turns. These are mirror image of each other. ये एक दूसरे के just mirror image हैं. Most frequently, beta turns are found in one of these two types. Then here is the torsion and rotations. Okay, let me clear the screen. Okay, so you know, sir, in the yes, please.
Sir, loops के अंदर क्या difference होता है?
Loops का क्या difference means?
सर एक तो अभी आपने बीटा टर्न्स का बताया ना, एक सिर्फ प्रोटीन के अंदर लूप्स भी तो बनती है ना, यानी
बीटा टर्न्स दीस आर सिमिलर थिंग्स. यहां पे ये लिखा हुआ है टाइट टर्न्स, रिवर्स टर्न्स एंड बीटा बैंड्स. बैंड्स को भी तो यही चीज होती है. लूप्स, दी लूप्स एंड बैंड्स, दीस आर सिमिलर थिंग इन द 3D स्ट्रक्चर. ठीक है, इसके अंदर हम लूप्स डिस्कस नहीं कर रहे हैं. दीज आर एक्चुअली पार्ट ऑफ टर्न्स. जितने भी टर्न्स हैं इनको हम बीटा टर्न्स कहते हैं, बीटा लूप्स कहते हैं, टाइट टर्न्स कहते हैं, रिवर्स टर्न्स कहते हैं. ठीक है, दीज आर द लूप्स. यही जो लूप्स हैं दैट्स आर अलाउइंग प्रोटीन टू फॉल इटसेल्फ, राइट? सो why and how these turns are formed. This is due to the jitne bhi protein ke andar jo structural variation aata hai, that's are due to two main bonds. One bond is the phi bond and this is psi bond. Okay, phi bond is between C and the phi bond is psi bond is between CC bond. So if you are looking here, this is the primary structure. Okay, primary structure, and this is the backbone of amino acid. In the backbone of amino acid, there is carbon CN bond. Hamesha CN CC bond hota hai, aisa hi hai. So this bond, carbon, if the alpha carbon and the carboxyl carbon ke darmiyan jo carbon hai, is bond ko hum psi bond kehte hain, right? Or similarly, agar alpha carbon aur jo nitrogen ke darmiyan hai bond hai, is bond ko hum phi bond kehte hain, theek hai? And so more statically, okay, we will discuss in the next slide ki ye kaise rotate hota hai ek dusre se, theek hai, aur rotation se kya effect padta hai structure ke upar. But in this slide you should know what is phi bond and what is psi bond. Okay, here is little bit discussion about okay, yahan pe show nahi ho raha. Anyhow, so if you are looking here, there are two main amino acids that are involved in the rotation. Jitne bhi rotation hai usme do main amino acids hai. Kya hai? Proline and glycine. Proline, you know, proline is a cyclic structure. Okay, proline is a cyclic structure and glycine is highly flexible. Okay, due to this simplicity of glycine and due to the cyclic structure of proline, these are mainly involved in the turns. Jitne bhi turns hote hain, unke andar glycine ya proline involved hota hai. Theek hai? Then here is the quality assessment of secondary structure. This is a Ramachandran plot. We have already discussed during the during our practical session. Jaise usme Swiss modeler mein humne jo homology base par humne protein structure ko predict kiya tha, usme humne ek point wahan pe bhi ek heading discuss kiya tha, Ramachandran plot. That was to check the quality of the secondary structure of protein. Okay, so Ramachandran plot, this is on the name of G and Ramachandran, and it was originally developed in 1963 by G and Ramachandran. Okay, Ramachandran was a scientist, biophysicist. So there are four yahan pe aap dekh rahe the blocks hain, aur in four blocks ke andar here is the phi angle. Ye x axis ke upar phi angle hai aur y axis ke upar psi angle hai. Phi angle 0 means this is phi angle 0. Agar phi angle 180 hai to this is phi angle 180 and this is phi angle minus 180. So this region, ye jo region hai, this is the pair of phi and psi. Theek hai, phi bond or phi angle or psi bond angle ke darmiyan jo ratio hai ya pair hai, wo is in region mein hoga. Theek hai, hamesha protein mein, you know, there are phi and psi bond. So phi bond agar ek ho to usi hisab se psi bond bhi, psi bond ke andar bhi angle hota hai. Theek hai, we will also discuss about the phi and psi rotation. This should be known. There are four regions. Aap dekh rahe hain ki, this is white region. white regions are sterically disallowed for all amino acid except glycine. Okay, just wait. So agar koi amino acids is region mein fall kare, white region mein, ye jo white region hai jahan jitne bhi white region hai in mein fall kare, it means our structure is not quite good. हम ये कह सकते हैं जो हमने स्ट्रक्चर प्रिडिक्ट किया है उसकी क्वालिटी इतनी अच्छी नहीं है. ओके, देन हेयर इज द रेड रीजन, दीस आर द रेड रीजन्स, एंड रेड रीजन्स मींस हाईली एक्सेप्टेबल अलाउड रीजन. ठीक है, हाईली एक्सेप्टेबल. सो हमारे जितने भी अगर हम 3D स्ट्रक्चर डिज़ाइन करते हैं तो उसकी क्वालिटी हम चेक करने के लिए हम इसको यूज़ कर सकते हैं. जितने भी हमारे प्रोटीन है 3D स्ट्रक्चर जो सेकेंडरी स्ट्रक्चर के अंदर, वो इस रीजन के अंदर फॉल करना चाहिए. दीस आर द एक्चुअल रीजन डिज़ाइंड बेस्ड ऑन एक्सपेरिमेंटली एंड प्रैक्टिकली वैलिडेटेड प्रोटीन. जितने भी अभी तक स्ट्रक्चरली एंड जो फिजिकली प्रोटीन को वैलिडेट किया है उसकी बेस पर ये रामाचंद्रन प्लॉट ड्रॉ किया गया है. ठीक है, सो नेचुरली नेचुरल में जितने भी प्रोटीन्स है उनको क्रिस्टलाइज फॉर्म में कन्वर्ट करने के बाद उनका स्ट्रक्चर वैलिडेट किया है. हम आगे पढ़ेंगे कौन कौन सा टेक्निक्स है जिनमें हम प्रोटीन स्ट्रक्चर प्रोटीन स्ट्रक्चर फाइंड कर सकते हैं थ्रू NMR एंड एक्सरे क्रिस्टलोग्राफी के जरिए. सो सिमिलरली दिस ब्लू रीजन, येलो रीजन, सॉरी येलो रीजन, दिस इज आउटलाइन लिमिट. ठीक है, मींस एक्सेप्टेबल. इस रीजन में भी आ जाए तो इसका मतलब है कि ये एक्सेप्टेबल है. दीज आर द बाउंड्रीज ऑफ अमाइनो एसिड्स. ठीक है, नॉट सो गुड बट एक्सेप्टेबल. बट दीज रेड रीजन्स आर रेड रीजन्स आर हाईली एक्सेप्टेबल. ओके, जितने भी बीटा शीट्स हैं, बीटा शीट शुड बी फॉल इन दिस रीजन. एंड सिमिलरली प्रोटीन के अंदर देर आर ऑल्सो प्रोटीन 3D स्ट्रक्चर कंप्राइजेस ऑफ बीटा शीट्स, अल्फा हेलिक्स एंड टर्न्स आर लूप्स. ओके, सो अल्फा हेलिसिस शुड बी फॉल इन दिस रीजन and the beta sheet should be fall in this region and the small turns and loops should be fall in this region. Okay, is region ke andar acceptable hai. Here is again similar thing. If you are looking here, these are the agar is form mein is region ke upar agar fall kare to it's means these belong amino acid belongs to anti parallel sheet. If fall in this region, this means parallel beta sheets, and similarly if found in this region, it means collagen triple helices, and this region shows right twisted beta sheets. Okay, right twisted beta sheets mean this like structure. Is tarah ke structure banne wale jo amino acids hain, that should be fall in this region. Okay, these dots. Then this is again left-handed alpha helices should be fall in this region, and this is right-handed alpha helices. Most of the structure are found in right-handed alpha helices. Okay, so here is a little bit difference in the collagen triple helices. Even this looks like helix, but due to the presence of high number of glycine and proline, iske andar jitne bhi collagen hai na, collagen molecules hai, jo collagen proteins hai, collagen proteins are mostly involved in structural protein. Aage jaake hum classification bhi padhenge ki kaun se protein function ke hisab se, structure ke hisab se kis class mein hai. So here is example ki jo collagen proteins hai, collagen protein ke andar glycine on proline jo content hai wo bahut zyada hai. Is wajah se kya hota hai iske andar, it fails to form a regular alpha helix and beta sheet structure. Yahi jo due to the abundance of glycine and proline, ye ek regular beta sheet se helices nahi bana sakta. ठीक है, देयर फॉर इट इज लिटिल ए बिट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम अल्फा हेलिक्स एंड बीटा शीट्स. Here is again, this is the principle of Ramachandran plot, that there are again three regions, alpha helices, beta strand region, and the tenth region are most likely conformation for a polypeptide chain to adopt, because most other conformations are impossible due to the steric collision between atoms. Okay, I think it should be there a little bit. Okay, it should be like this. So this is again same thing, the phi bond and the psi bond. Okay, this is a dihedral angles. Why this is known as dihedral? इसको डाइहेड्रल हम इस वजह से कहते हैं, बिकॉज़ दिस आर द बॉन्ड दैट्स आर फाउंड इन बिटवीन टू प्लेन्स. Two plane, this is one plane, this is another plane, and these are found in the intersecting region of the two plane. Is wajah se isko hum dihedral angles kehte hain, theek hai. And the plane, agar aap ye is plane ke andar hain to yahan se rotation aisa bhi ho sakta hai, to plane change ho sakta hai, is form mein bhi plane change ho sakta hai. So these are the two plane, theek hai. In do plane ke darmiyan mein phi aur psi bond hai, jiski wajah se plane hamesha change hota rehta hai. Okay, then this is again showing a published article results. एक पेपर पब्लिश्ड हुआ जो 2003 में, जिसमें बहुत सारे प्रोटीन्स को एक साथ उनका स्ट्रक्चर चेक किया गया, तो दीज डॉट्स आर रिप्रेजेंटिंग अमीनो एसिड्स. Okay, amino acid, if you are looking here, most of the amino acids are falling either in beta regions or alpha regions, okay, or in trans region, yeah, or left-handed helices region. So there are very little bit amino acid. These black dots are showing amino acids. The black dots hai na, ye black dots showing, these are disallowed region ke andar hai. So okay, here is not any other information. Then if you are looking here, this is a 3D structure of alanine, simply alanine, jo dots region hai, these regions, ye jo dots ke sath region hai, this showing the alanine structure. Okay, alanine structure ko agar aap dekhe to, and this region, these colors are showing the peptide bond. This color are showing peptide bond. Alpha helices, alpha carbon, this color show alpha helix, this is the oxygen, this is carbon, and this is hydro. These whites are showing hydrogen and nitrogen. Okay, then here is showing the phi bond and the psi bond again. Okay, now this is the important about the phi bond. Let's suppose this is a carbon molecule atom 1, 2 and 4 ke darmiyan jo bond hai wo kya hai, phi bond hai. In this form, is form mein dono ek hi side pe plane pe hain, so the angle of phi bond is zero. Okay, is form mein zero pe hain. Ab aage dekhenge ki kaise change hota hai. Okay, this is again. Okay, what's happening with this one? Due to the slight content change from Windows to Linux, it's causing a little bit problem. Okay, just wait. Please rejoin the meeting. I will shift to the another window system. Okay.